guys, off again today, testing out a tyre combo, Maxxis Forecaster and Maxxis Aspen. See how good this tyre combo is. And as you can see, I've changed my bars. I put a 34 tooth chainring on instead of a 32. I put a 180 disc on the front instead of the 203. And this bike feels a hell of a lot better already. I say, it's been that combination that you need. Hold it. This side, use this side. So, I'm going to get some rear views today. Look where the camera on. And
oh my god, brain. Linda, I think they just can't see bikes.
Oh, we got the heron. There's the heron here. Have a doing a bit of fishing. Oh, look at that, them squeaky brakes. See the heron there? Beautiful bird. Not worth having the rear camera on. So, what was about that?
Very still.
Let's go. I'm Robin then. Nice name. Oh, had a bird top today. Alright. Thought I'd get out of the tree earlier. With a kingfisher. Please don't. Up.
get through.
There we go. So, on for the climb. Third gear. Through second gear. Not that hard, I suppose. You know something? These tyres, this combo, feels better than the recon race tyres. So here we are, again at the dam, on splats. Have a wander around, see how these tyres perform, and to be honest they feel running great. I say, I was talking to one of the XC riders, pro riders, and he recommended this combo. Thank you very much. So, start off here again in a bit. So away we go. A few little more snapshots. Here's on these 26 kilometre run, or 29 kilometre run today. So, depending on how I feel, might be a little bit. Here's on these 26 kilometre run, or 29 kilometre run today. So, depending on how I feel, might be a little bit. Yeah. So, we get into the more muddy stuff, which isn't really what these tyres are made for. It's not a hard pack. Okay, the front is, the rear's not. But you can see, there we go. So, we get into the more muddy stuff, which isn't really what this thing is made for. Quite hard pack.
Yes, it is muddy.
Okay, the front is. Yep. The rear is not the rear. You can see, there we go. There's a lot of fun ones out today. A lot of falls on the ground. Here's a lot. Yep, these out. Put them underneath the other.
Yes, it's on the muddy as well today.
So one thing else, the loader. A lot better. There's a lot of fun ones out today. A lot of fun ones on the ground. A lot. Put them underneath the other discs on the front. Yeah. Well, thank you.
Cheers.
A lot better.
Cheers.
Don't forget to do one thing again. Don't put your seat up. Yes, I've got my help. Not too bad. No point. Hopefully there's not too much mud on me. Camera lens at the back. I'll check it out a bit. Probably covered by now.
little bit muddy today. Just they poured it down last night. I don't think it'll be up here anyway. So, I wasn't going to try and go up that in these conditions. Okay, I bike and one breaker. I'm going to just slew up it. We've got XC race tyres on. And it's muddy as hell today. This is actually too much mud for these tyres, but you know, not really the mud tyre. To be honest, actually done better in the recon race. Yes.
Go on.
Right. What the hell? I might go too fast afterwards. Yeah, it's looking up everywhere. Oh, quite a bit of mud here. Not bad. WTV tyres going to be testing as well, and Victoria tyres. Got the bars on, Mezcal, Sierra, and WTV tyres. Some breakouts I've got. The Ranger and let's avoid that. And the Trail Boss. I've got the Trail Boss on the back. Either the Ranger Oh, brake out. Is it brake out? On the front. Oh, I'm covered in mud. Cheers. Tread paddles in here. Somebody else has been here this morning. I don't know, it isn't last night. Because it rained last night and they would have been all covered. So we're on old pack today. Bit too good for this bike, really. Thank you. I see my bit. Cheers. Morning. Cheers. Yes. My thoughts on the tyres. I'll let you know when I get back home. So I'm now back home, and what did I think of these tyres? I've got to say, absolutely fantastic combination. Very happy with this. It roll, you know, this Aspen. I've got to say, it did roll very nice. I would actually put this on par with the Racing Ralph, and I absolutely adore that tyre. One of the best tyres, rolling tyres, okay, you know. And this isn't far from it. That is a cracking tyre, and to be honest, this Forecaster, I'll say, is better than the Racing Ray. You know, this will be Racing Ralph on the back, this Forecaster on the front. That's one hell of a combination. Because this thing, I know it was a little bit muddy, I have to admit, you know,
But I did want to get out on the bike. I did want to test these tyres out. It was like a bog around there, and it was, yes, the bike was slipping around and that, but they did hold their own, especially the back tyre, you know, for such a small amount of grip on it, it didn't do too bad. So I'd say definitely a rear XC tyre. Forecaster is most definitely a front tyre. Love that combination. Yeah, it was a nice ride, and I've got to say, I think I've just about got this bike right, because, well, like I said in the video, I changed this front disc from a 203 to a 180, and it still performed absolutely fantastic. And then I put the race face carbon bars on. But these are the riser bars. There's not much of a rise in them, but I've got to say, much better than the flat bars. Felt better, handled better. So this bike is just about complete in part spec. Now I am going to be putting some different tyres on it next week. I was going to use the Trek, but I thought, you know, I'll keep to the same bike. Simple fact being, Trek is a completely different style of bike for, you know, for riding around on compared to this. So I need to keep the tyres on the same bike to test them out. So I'm going to give these, I know I didn't give a mark to the what's his name's, the Recon Race. I'll give the Recon Race, I'll give them a 6 out of 10. This combination I've got on now, I'm gonna give these a 9 for this combination I've got. Like I say, loved how loved how the bike was handling with them on. It just worked. This combination works. So thanks, buddy, for suggesting this combo. Very happy with this. It's actually what he uses. I can't tell you his name, but it's what he actually uses in his XC racing. So, but anyway, next week I'm hoping to get out somewhere different, but all depends on the weather and that. I will be using, so for the rear, I'm going to be putting on, this is my WTB Trail Boss. So down here, so you can see, this is going to be going on the back. It's got very tight knit tread on it. You can see WTBs. So this is a 225. So I'm going to have that on the back. And then on the front, now this is more of a rear enduro style, but this also works great on the front. So this is the WTB breakout. It's a 2.3, 29er obviously. And check the tread pattern out on that. So this combination is a bit more aggressive. So these probably would have worked better in the muddy conditions today. But like I say, I wanted to test the Forecaster and the Aspen out, as it was recommended to me. So this is a really nice combination that I'm going to do next week. So let's have a look. There's two different tread patterns on them. So rear, front. So I'm going to try them out. And then I've got, now I know this other combination works because it was actually used for the World XC Championships, and the guy who uses them won. So it's the Vittoria Barzo for the front, and the Vittoria Mezcal on the rear. But I've got the Mezcal F, which is a little bit, well, you'll see it anyway when I put it on the bike. And I've also got, which I'm going to be testing as well, the Vittoria Sierra. So they're going to get tested as well. So anyway, guys, I'm going to give these a 9 out of 10 for performance and everything. I know they'll suit the drier ground better. That's basically what I really needed to test them on, but they held their own in the mud. So I'm very happy with this combo. So I'm going to say Wicked Wills, if I was going to rate them, I'm just going to give them a straight 10. The Johnny Watts 365s were tested. I'm going to give them 8. You would have got an 8.5 except for the weight. So we'll see what these are. Like me, what's the name? Maybe Racing Ralphs and Racing Rays. I'm also going to give them a, I'd say for the, what's his name, a 10 for the Racing Ralph and an 8 for the Racing Ray. But like I say, I'm loving this combo I've got on here now, and I will be testing more tyres, and I'll actually do a review on all the tyres I've got, because like I say, I've got a lot of tyres. So anyway, guys, I'm going to cut it here. Keep watching. Hit that subscribe button if you already haven't. And I will see you all soon.